So today we'll be continuing with our main motive of doing 50 journal entries at one go. Now 50 journal entries may sound like a lot, but obviously it's gonna take a little bit of time and patience. If this video stretches for too long, I'm obviously gonna give a break and divide it into two parts, okay? So let's start with the entire concept of journal entries. Now we did three basic journal entries to start you off with about what debit and credit looks like, what the format is, right? So we'll be starting off with 50 most common journal entries, and the questions will be apparently displayed onto your screen kind of like this, or maybe just like this, anywhere. So we'll just start off with the concept, and hopefully you enjoy this video, and I would 100% recommend you to do this entire concept with me. By the way, the entire document of 50 journal entries, in case you want to take a printout, is given in the link in the description below. So if you want to download and print it out and do this particular thing with us right now, you can do it, not a problem. Otherwise, the entries will be displayed. So I have already drawn this format last time we discussed it. Date, particulars, ledger folio, there's also this voucher number, but apparently both will not be used. So I thought to conserve some space. And debit column and then credit column, right? So we started off with every concept. Now date we are not going to use today, we'll be just using serial numbers so that we can easily track what we are actually doing, which number we are actually on to. So we start off with the very first journal entry, which is obviously starting a business with cash, right? So started business with cash, rupees 1 lakh. So serial number 1, or if you wish, you can give another artificial date. Started business with cash. That means cash is coming into business. So cash account debit to what is going out? Capital account. Nothing is actually going out, but this particular reason is the entire phenomena why cash is coming in, right? So cash account debit to capital account. The reason is credited. Amount is rupees 1 lakh. Now for the very first one, I am giving a narration, but obviously I'll not be giving narrations for each and every journal entries because it's gonna take a lot of time. So being business, being cash brought into business or something, and then close the brackets. So that is narration, okay? First entry is clear, cash account debit to capital account. Next, purchased goods for cash. Apparently purchased goods rupees, say suppose 20,000. When we say purchased goods 20,000 and the medium of purchase, that means we have not been mentioned how we purchase the goods, for cash, by check, by bank draft or anything. It has not been mentioned, right? Just we are informed about a purchase event being happening. On such a case where the medium of payment is not mentioned and neither is the name of the buyer or the seller, then what we do, we consider it to be cash. So purchased goods for cash rupees 20,000. What is coming into business? Goods in the name of purchases are coming in. Purchases account debit to what is going out? Cash account. Amount is 20,000, right? Next, third one, sold goods. Again, nothing has been given. 25,000 rupees, sold goods 25,000 for cash. We assume for cash. So cash is coming into business right now because we are selling off the goods. Two sales. Amount will be 25,000 and 25,000. Done. These three entries we had previously discussed, very brief idea, so hopefully you know. Next we start off with number 4, opened bank account or deposited into bank rupees 50,000. So we have 1 lakh rupees we brought in cash into business, so now we decided to open up a bank account, right? For how much rupees? 50,000. We opened up a bank account or we deposited cash into bank. On a daily basis we do it, right? We go to the bank, we deposit some cash. So here what happens, we did not deposit the money into our personal accounts. We opened up a new account in the name of the company itself, in the name of, sorry, the business itself, the sole proprietorship itself, and we deposited the money. So the bank account belongs to the company itself, right? The bank account is in the name of the business, in the books of the business. So the money is not going to the owner's house. It's going and it's staying in the business for further use. So a new account is created, which is known as bank account, right? So currently we were doing all the transactions in cash account. Now we have bank account. So the money is being transferred from liquid cash state to bank account, right? So what will be debited? Bank account increases. Bank account debit to what is going out? Cash account. So what is happening here? From the business hands only, the cash is going out and the business money is taking another form, which is being deposited into the bank. So bank is being debited and cash is going out. Amount is how much? 50,000. Right? Next, look at number 5. Purchased goods by check. Purchased goods by check, rupees 10,000. So this time I have a bank account and I want to purchase and make the payment by check. Can do that. So again, purchases account debit. But this time cash is not going out. This time cash is not going out. Last time when we purchased something, cash was going out. This time what will go out? My bank account balance will reduce. That is why to bank. Check means, what does a check mean? C-H-E-Q-U-E. Check refers to a payment being made by the bank. Hopefully you would have a bank account. If not, then consult your guardians. So what is the amount? Number 5, 10,000. Correct. Next, number 6, sold goods by check, 12,000. So this time I am receiving payment by check. So my bank will increase, bank account debit. What is coming in? A check is coming in, and of course the money will drop right into the bank. Bank account debit to sales account, selling the goods. Amount is 12,000. Okay, I'm gonna rub this thing off. Hopefully till now it is all clear. Now all these 7 entries are actually pretty easy. But we have to complete 50, and slowly and gradually the competitiveness or the hardness of the sum will start to increase. The difficulty is going to increase. So we start off with number 7. Purchased goods from Mr. Ramesh. Serial number 7. Purchased goods from Mr. Ramesh. Amount is how much? 20,000. Now when we usually purchase goods, what do we give? Cash, right? You purchase goods from someone, we assume you are giving him cash. Cash or maybe check. Whenever the name of the person is mentioned, by rule, always remember this. Whenever the name of the person is mentioned and his medium of exchange is not given, that means you have not been provided with whether he or she is giving us cash or check or anything, and just the name has been given. Like here, we purchased goods from Mr. Ramesh, right? We purchased the goods. So it has not been mentioned by cash, by check or anything. So we will consider this type of transaction to be credit transaction. Credit, that means we did not pay the amount right now, we will pay him later. This is known as credit transaction. So purchased goods from Mr. Ramesh, 20,000. goods will be coming in the name of purchases account debit. Two, usually we used to write down cash or bank. This time, because the name has been mentioned, we will use the name itself. Mr. Ramesh. $20,000. All right. Next, we move on to number 8. Sold goods to Mr. Binod. Same thing applies. Sold goods to Mr. Binod. So this time we have Binod with an amount of rupees 25,000. Refers to sales. Medium of exchange not mentioned. Whether cash or bank not given. Hence, his name will be debited. Usually cash or bank is debited. Mr. Binod account debit to sales account. Is it clear? Clear? So whenever name is mentioned, we use the name instead of cash or bank. That means credit transaction. Next, we start off with number 9, received from Mr. Binod, 25,000. Now, this is important. We received, first of all, we sold goods to Mr. Binod, right? How much? 25,000 worth of goods we sold to him. Now, he is paying us back the money, right? So, received from Mr. Binod, what did we receive? Nothing has been mentioned. Assume it to be cash. Cash account debit to whom did we receive it from? Mr. Binod? To Mr. Binod account, what is the entire amount? 25,000, right? He received 25,000. Okay, so we at first sold goods to him on credit, comes to us, gives us the entire money. Next is paid Mr. Ramesh rupees 20,000. So first we sold goods, he paid to us. Now it's our courtesy to pay the particular person we bought goods from on credit the money back. So purchases account debit to Mr. Ramesh. Now we will pay him the money. So Mr. Ramesh is the person we are paying to and his name is being written off. So Mr. Ramesh account debit, because debit the receiver. Remember the golden rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here, who is giving us the money? In transaction number 9, Binod, Mr. Binod is giving us the money. Hence, he is being credited. Credit the giver. And here, who is the receiver? Mr. Ramesh. Mr. Ramesh account debit to what is going out of our pockets? Cash. Amount will be how much? 20,000. 20,000. Clear? And cash is a real account, right? So we have to take care about it. Go through these 10 transactions.